certainly has those growth prospects. As I said earlier on, there are some things that we certainly need to get right here, particularly the infrastructure point, but we have a breathing space, a bit of a breathing space now, and rather doing lots of breathing, we should get on with the infrastructure. For a bank that's investing here, for an investor here, there are three things. One, do you have the capacity to invest? Well, I think the operating performances of many of these banks is actually very good. The question is whether their levels of non-performing loans will really prevent them having the capacity. But then it's a question of desire and comparability between countries. And if I looked at comparing, it's a question then of a return and the size of the return that you can get and the sustainability of that return. And if I look at Romania, I can see a scale country, 22 million people, still relatively underdeveloped in terms of financial services product take-up, and good returns. So over the longer term, so on both capacity and desire, it's there for those reasons. And I think finally making it happen is then about timing and about when that investment is required. You should be able to generate returns organically within some of these markets. So reinvesting your current returns is an important part of this. The second then avenue is gaining extra capital, but that's a second avenue rather than a first.
So, I mean, there's obviously a lot of debate about whether the European institutions, whether the European Central Bank or the Commission or others have been sending the right signals or been providing enough help. I mean, you don't feel that, is there anything that they could do in terms of sending signals that would help the situation that they haven't done, would you say?
No, I think it's the good thing is that there is coordinated action. So what we see is a coordinated action between the IMF, the EU, and a number of the IFIs. I think that's particularly important. And I think it's maybe even more important that it's coordinated action than that some action maybe was taken sooner. I also think it is important that not to overreact. I mean, at a certain moment, we need to get things right. And if we see in the West, I mean, enormous amounts have been made available, enormous amounts of liquidity have been injected, I suppose, at a certain cost. But the effects of that were quite minimal. So also in the beginning, there were voices that said, well, Romania has to do this, Romania has to do that, the authorities have to do such, and the authorities have to do so. Well, I think there was maybe not a very abrupt reaction, but in the end, I think we can only include that things have been managed rather well and seem to be under control. And the plan that has been put in place is generally welcomed, and for Romania, indeed seen as some sort of model that is maybe also the way forward for other countries. So, from that point of view, it's always easy to criticize, but no.
We've had the same message from both central bankers and commercial bankers, the mismatch between resources and the lending. And I was paying attention at what Mr. Brunsill said about three different retailers and categories. The honest one, the second one, they can't pay the loans, and the third category, the one who are avoiding